The Panchatantra stories are fables based mostly on animals and always end with a moral. These stories illuminate the qualities of human nature and form a wonderful part of the Indian heritage. They give lessons in survival in a fiercely competitive world. The stories narrated involve animals and birds. Vishnu Sharma made the animals and birds speak and behave like humans. These are the famous Panchatantra stories. The Panchatantra speaks about the five ways that help the human being succeed in life. Pancha means five, and Tantra means ways or principles. The five heads under which stories are narrated in the Panchatantra are loss of friends, gain of friends, causing dissension between friends, loss of gains, ill-considered action. One day, in the heavens, the sun god and the wind god met.
It's a long time since we met.
Yes, the workload is great and I don't find time.
Of course, it's the same with me too.
Your work goes on in predictable lines, but I have to change my course many times in a season.
Oh, that's true of my work too.
Don't talk nonsense. My work is more challenging. You are not even seen for months in some places.
The sun god got wild.
Without me, there would be no light in the world.
Without me, there would be no life.
The argument between the wind and the sun became aggressive. It was now a prestige issue as to who of the two was stronger. The wind claimed that he was stronger than the sun. There seemed to be no end to the argument.
Sun and wind, please stop your argument. Either of you has to do something to prove your point. All right, I will prove it to all of you.
Just then, they saw a traveler walking down the road. The sun got a bright idea.
Let's test our strength on that man. The one who is able to make him take off his jacket shall be considered the winner. Is that okay with you?
Ha ha! Such an easy test. I will do it in a minute.
Welcome. Show me how you can do it.
The sun hid himself behind clouds and got ready to see the fun. The wind took the first turn. He blew an icy blast.
Oh, what an icy wind!
He kept his jacket tight. The wind blew harder. The harder he blew, the more closely did the traveler wrap his jacket around his body. The wind tried everything. Clung to every ruse. He heaved his stormy power from all sides, but all in vain. His confidence of his mightiness began to wane. Finally tired and fuming, the wind gave up. Now, it was the sun's turn.
Try now. Let me see what you can do.
The sun gently put aside the bank of clouds which served as a veil a moment ago. The clouds disappeared, and now the sun shone brightly. The traveler felt the heat.
What's happening today? Sudden changes in climate. The sun is very warm after the icy blast.
Gradually, the sun grew hotter and hotter. The traveler first loosened his jacket and then finally took it off. He began to perspire. He sat in the shade of a tree and fanned himself. He took his jacket and wiped his face. The sun had proved himself to be stronger than the wind.
Sun, you have proved your might.
The wind is also equally powerful, but if he has chosen some other test, I would have lost. I chose this test because I knew he would lose. One should always work in the area of one's strength.
Thank you, Sun, for sharing your wisdom. Please forgive me.
Panchatantra teaches us about human nature and shows us how to be successful in a world made up of many sorts of people. It shows us that we should choose reliable and trustworthy friends and face difficulties and problems with tact and wisdom. It teaches us how we can achieve success in the face of hypocrisy and deceit. The Panchatantra is a rare collection of stories in which you find philosophy, psychology, politics, music, astronomy, and human relationships discussed in a simple yet elegant style. This is exactly what Pandit Vishnu Sharma had in mind when he set about putting sense into some princes. For many, many centuries, even lay readers have benefited from the extraordinary tales that figure in this program.